I grew up in a farming community in Newport. As a young boy and my grandparents, they had an acre farm, which is a lot. You know, all the aunts and uncles and everybody came over and farmed. It was ingrained in us. My name is Rob Galloway. We're at the nursery here in Little Rock, Arkansas. We are a nursery that has a farm component to it. We're the only hydroponic and homebrew supply store in Central Arkansas. It's merged the farm with the residential retail sales. And I've been telling a lot of people that, you know, we're trying to just farm and trying to teach people to farm. That's really my goal here. All of our lettuce production and those foods are grown with hydroponic nutrients. And so I'm supplying the nutrients to the water. Hydroponics is really just growing plants in a soilless medium. I mean, it can be just rock wool, cocoa core, any kind of, I mean, just pebbles. You know, so you just put the plant into the medium and then you get the water with nutrients in it. So that's really all it boils down to. It's lettuce, it's leafy greens, you know, right now. And so we can do, you know, bib lettuce, romaine lettuce, all the curly ones, all the red ones, you know, collard greens, turnip greens. We can do bok choy, Swiss chard, herbs, anything you really want to grow. Tomatoes, cucumbers, squash, zucchini. I've done pumpkins, watermelons. We sell to some restaurants here locally, any kind of food bank or any kind of nonprofit. And the purpose of farming is great because you're bringing something to life, you're managing it, you're sharing it with others, you're bringing people together. It has a lot of the boxes that you check. So in hydroponics, we're really a water quality control company. You know, that's the way I kind of look at it. If my water's great, and then my plants are happy. You have to start with your source water, and you just make sure that the pH is balanced. So then you add your nutrients. If it's too much, you're gonna make them sick. And if you starve them to death and don't put enough nutrients in the water, then they're gonna do the same thing. They're just gonna starve to death. So you find that magic number for whatever crop you're growing, and then you get the right amount of nutrients in there. Shooting for a target around 1600. I have a little acronym that's called Deep Lawns. Lawns would be lights, air, water, nutrients, and seeds. You have to have all of those to grow plants, right? And then the deep would be the disease, energy, equipment, and pest. Those are some of the critical failure points, right? Those are some of the things that's gonna take out your farm. You're gonna have success if you just do the basic water things, right? Just trial and error, DIY, a few cycles of just doing the water, seeing how it goes. My plants aren't growing, you know, they're short, they're not doing right, they're sick, and it's really you just start diagnosing the symptoms at that point. Online, there's a million videos out there. This is just basic 101 stuff. I mean, and people will have success with it. It's just gonna be how much yield based on your farm, which could be your bedroom or 25 greenhouses. On a home level, you know, hydroponics can be as grandiose as you would want it or as simple as you want it. You can have it just so it's on a rack, on a table, on a shelf, or the plant just sits in water, one plant. Or you could scale it to a Sam's rack that you could get off the shelf and then put 150 plants on there. So you can scale it to whatever you want to at home. A 2-foot by 6-foot rack with 4 shelves, you can get 36 plants harvested on one shelf. So if you dedicate 2 of those shelves for your grow space, you can get 72 plants on there. So really, you know, 20 plants a week would not be out of the question, 30 plants a week, 40 plants a week. It's just really how well you are at managing your tool as a farmer. If you talk about what's important in hydroponics, it uses 90 to 95% less water, right? I mean, we are in drought issues. The second one is that it opens up all boundaries. You can grow when the soil's not good, if it's rocks, if you don't have the land, et cetera, all of those things. But the third one is really just gonna be about the quality. The reports say that your produce can lose 50% of its nutritional value within the first 24 hours of being harvested. We can harvest it today and get it to you. Hydroponics can bring that step closer to you getting more of the nutritional values from it. With the hydroponic, you'll get faster yields, you know, so you're gonna get a bigger plant that grows faster, that's healthier, and then it can be harvested whenever you want it. Another thing hydroponics does is get you indoors, those extra levels of protection from these crazy weather swings we're having right now. If you're into tech stuff, I mean, I'm into automation, and so all my farm is getting built around automation. You know, for my farm, I can manage all of my inputs of the sun, the shade cloths, the fans, my flow meters, my pumps, my lighting, and then they're telling me too, if my water nutrients are wrong, it'll dose it for me. So the redundancy's getting put into place, so it really increases yields by decreasing some of the symptoms because you can catch them earlier. Right now, we make a really good product. We keep our nutrient levels constant. You know, we keep all the system constant. There's only like three of us working here at this nursery. That's it. I'm 7 days a week. I mean, 1,000 plants a week is totally doable in this greenhouse with one person. Moving a lot of customers through here is doable with one or two people. Some of the challenges that we face in hydroponics industry is just getting people to adopt it, just getting them to do it at a home level. Hydroponics, what it does, it opens up boundaries. And you know, if you don't have big money and big opportunities, and you can't go get big land, do you have a spare bedroom? We can provide for our families by growing. And if we can start at our home and start growing individually, then you can help your neighbors. People are wanting to try to get into farming, and this is a great way to do it without spending a lot of money. And if you don't have those big ag deals, like we said, you can go and start in your home.
This segment of Good Roots is made possible by support from Acre Trader.